Two of the greatest mysteries of astrophysics today is dark matter and black holes. Regarding dark matter, it's simply not known what this material is, other than it has a profound effect gravitationally on the rest of the universe. Candidates for what it could be include things like undetected subatomic particles that only interact with other particles through gravity and no other way, but another candidate seems to stand out, or at least may, for a portion of the missing mass in the universe. It's the concept of primordial black holes, and further, it's plausible that one could be rather close to us, perhaps uncomfortably so. The concept of a primordial black hole goes back to the 1960s and was first studied in depth by Stephen Hawking in the early 70s. The idea is this: during the initial aftermath of the Big Bang, literally about 1 second after its thought, densities were such that black holes could form that were far smaller than the stellar collapse black holes that we're most familiar with today. It's thought that these types of black holes would generally not have been very long-lived in terms of the age of the universe under a certain mass, and should have mostly evaporated by now. However, if string theory is correct, this may lengthen the life of a tiny primordial black hole. But above a certain mass, they might well still be around. And with ones that are gaining mass in high-density areas, they may have even served as the seed course for such things as supermassive black holes at the centers of galaxies. But the possibility of primordial black holes explaining dark matter recently took a major hit. Earlier this year, an international team studied the Andromeda Galaxy, looking for microlensing events. The idea here is that the immense space between us and Andromeda should be full of primordial black holes, and they would bend the light from the stars in Andromeda behind them in such a way as to be detectable. The results were interesting to say the least. While they essentially eliminated primordial black holes as a major component of dark matter through the lack of detections, they did see one that might have been a primordial black hole. This would suggest that yes, they exist, but they are significantly rarer than previous estimates. The team cautions, however, that certain other phenomena might account for the single detection, and that further study is needed to determine if it is indeed a primordial black hole. While contentious and hotly debated, as are many things regarding black holes, the concept of primordial black holes is still out there, if not a major candidate for dark matter. And if a recent paper ends up holding up true, there may be one much closer than anyone ever anticipated. In a paper by Jacob Scholtz and James Unwin, they detailed that the strange features seen with some of the objects in the outer solar system may not be due to a ninth planet lurking out there after all, but rather a primordial black hole. This ties into the Planet 9 story, see the videos on this channel for that topic, and this hypothesis is based on two gravitational anomalies of unknown origin that have been detected in the outer solar system and in deep space. One is a strange gravitational effect on certain trans-Neptunian objects in the outer solar system, leading to speculation that there may well be a ninth planet, or Planet 9, far out in the outer solar system. This planet has not yet been directly detected, if it's there at all, but could represent either a primordial planet ejected from somewhere in the inner solar system early in its history, or possibly even a captured rogue planet originally from somewhere else entirely. Trouble is, it's somewhat difficult to have a planet in the predicted orbit, though not impossible. The problem is that to form a planet that far out, you need material, and the density of material in the outer solar system isn't very high, making it unlikely that a large planet could form that far out. Another option is that it might either be an ejected planet from somewhere else in the solar system, or even a planetary core from a forming gas giant that was tossed out. But again, there are problems with the physics of how it managed to go into an outer orbit without leaving the solar system entirely. The last option for a planet is the captured rogue planet idea. Space is likely full of wandering planets that get tossed out of their original systems. It may be that the solar system captured one, though it's not very likely for such a thing to have happened, but it's certainly not impossible. The search for Planet 9 continues, but there's no reason to say that a primordial black hole couldn't be captured in the same way and at similar odds. The other anomaly is something else entirely. These are distant, unexplained microlensing events. Observed by the Ogle experiment, whatever's causing these, they are near the galactic plane and are gravitationally microlensing objects behind them. This could suggest a population of free-floating planets passing by in deep space, which is interesting enough, but could also be an indicator for primordial black holes. The researchers noticed that the predicted mass of Planet 9 is very similar to the predicted mass of a primordial black hole, so the two ideas may be linked. Perhaps most interestingly, the authors give a way for how such a black hole might be detected. If it exists, the primordial black hole would be surrounded by accumulated dark matter. If that dark matter were to annihilate with antimatter, then X-rays and gamma rays would be emitted and should be detectable. But even if it weren't detected directly, if no evidence of a Planet 9 is ever found, and the anomalies in the outer solar system continue to pile up, it will lead to a very interesting mystery indeed. On the other hand, if a tiny black hole lurks in the outer solar system, literally on our doorstep, it would revolutionize the study of black holes as we know it. Thanks for listening. I am futurist and science fiction author John Michael Godier, currently requesting that the primordial black hole please vacate the solar system to at least 10 light years distance or the nearest convenient empty patch of space nowhere close to Earth. We have an enormous star that's going to go red giant. Two huge, scary-looking gas giants, asteroids, comets, interstellar Oumuamuas passing through, gamma ray burst possibilities. In other words, we have enough to worry about already. We don't need to add a lurking close-by black hole to the list. Worries everywhere. So if you can't sleep at night, try one of my books, which you can get at your favorite online book retailer, and subscribe to my channels for regular in-depth explorations into the interesting, weird, and unknown aspects of this amazing universe in which we live.